Now, one thing that's important about the horizon is that the horizon isn't just something you make up, right? The horizon actually depends upon things like your discount factor. And if you have a very small discount factor, then so far out in the future, it doesn't matter what's happening anyway. And so you can do better. But if you have a reasonable discount factor, then you're going to have to look pretty far out in the future to get a good estimate of taking a particular action in a particular state.
Okay, makes sense.
Right. So this is both good and bad, right? Monte Carlo is kind of neat because it's sort of neat on its own. It's very useful. It's one way of dealing with scale. It's completely compatible with options and other things that we know. It has a bunch of dials in it that we can play with that sort of help us and that we might be able to take cool advantage of. But you still need lots and lots and lots and lots of samples in order to make it work, which is true for any Monte Carlo method.
So is there a sense in which we traded, you know, in big state spaces, we traded being exponential in the number of state features, say, for mm-hmm. instead exponential in the size of the horizon?
Yeah, and that trade-off is, it's right here, I suppose. This is our trade-off. And you're right, and that makes sense, right? So before, with the kind of algorithms that we've used before, you visit all the states, you back up information about them, and so on and so forth. So that clearly has to depend upon the number of states. Here, we're not worrying about the states. What we're doing is we're just looking forward into the future by doing simulation. And so every single time we have to look forward into the future, we have to look forward into the future. And perhaps we have to look forward very far into the future. And somehow, because we're doing this kind of Monte Carlo thing, we're doing kind of, I don't know, almost a non-parametric estimate of whatever the true transition model is. That's going to require lots and lots of states and more lots and lots of samples and more samples the further out into the future that we go. So we are going to be trading that off. We're always trading off kind of space versus time in a particular way, and here the space is represented by the states as opposed to the time, which is represented by how far out you're going to search.
Oh, that's nice.
Thank you.